Hi, and today I'm going to show you all the tools and techniques you need to know to change the size, the height, and divide your table cells. So let's just go up to Insert, go to Table, click on the drop down, and I'm just going to click and drag out a table. It doesn't really matter how many cells I've got. So the table's been inserted, and the way to select the entire table is to click on this box at the top left. That means that we can adjust all of the cells at the same time. And to do that, go to Layout, and then we can go along to this section here. So this is Height and Width. So if we want to increase the height of our cells, we can either click on this up arrow here. So if I just click a few times, that doesn't work, then simply enter in. Let's go to 1.5 centimeters and press Enter. You can see how that affects the tables there. And then you can also change the width. However, if you do change the width, let's take this up to... In fact, let's take this down to 2 and press Enter. You can see your table will no longer stretch the width of your document, but that's okay. If that's what you want, then that's how to do that. I'm just going to go back one step by pressing Command or Control Z. Another way you can change individual cells is, so if I just wanted to make this cell here a bit narrower, I'm going to have to move this line here. But if I just grab that line, you can see it will affect all four cells. I don't want to do that, so I need to tell Word I just want to select this one. So I click and drag across those two cells. That means now when I use this dividing line, so it means that now when I move this dividing line, it's only going to move that top one because I've selected those two cells. Again, as you saw before, if I want to move the line completely, then I can just click on it, wait till it changes to a double-headed arrow, and then I can move that line. If I want to split the cells, I can select a cell. Let's say I wanted to split this one in half, select it, go to Layout and go to Split Cells. We want to keep the number of rows, so we want to stay at one row, but we want to change it to two columns and click OK. And you can see we've now divided it into two columns. And again, you can adjust this line in the middle if you want to do so. If you want to split the row, so let's say I wanted to split this cell in half, so I had a row here and a row at the bottom. Again, go to Split Cells and then keep your column as one and then increase your number of rows to 2. Just hit that up arrow there and click OK. And now you can see how that's been split into 2 rows, but just that cell. And that's because we've just selected that cell. If you wanted to do it for the whole row, select the whole row, and just repeat that process. The difference is you are now being given a number of columns. We've got 10, we want to take it back down to 5 as it once was, as it is now, sorry. And then you want to increase the number of rows to 2, click OK, and there you can see it has converted them into 2 rows. If it nudges out, just select it and nudge that line back in. And then if, for example, you wanted to make this one complete cell, so these 4 cells here, if you wanted to make this into one complete cell, select them all, go to Layout, go along to Merge Cells and click. And that will merge all of those cells into one cell. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.